Granting hope, stories of Pelotonia-funded research at the Ohio State University Comprehensive Cancer Center, James Cancer Hospital, and Solove Research Institute. Immunotherapy is the next frontier for treating cancer. Unlike chemotherapy, immunotherapy seeks to mobilize the body's immune system to recognize and destroy cancer cells. In one form of immunotherapy, healthy white blood cells, known as T cells, are programmed to target a specific protein on cancerous tumor cell surfaces. The T cells are surgically removed from the tumor, grown in large numbers in a laboratory, then given back to the patient to help their immune system destroy the cancer cells. While this T cell therapy can be effective, it works for only a few types of cancer and a limited number of patients. Now, with the support of a Pelotonia Idea Grant, researchers at the James at Ohio State are working to make T-cell immunotherapy a viable treatment option for more cancers and more patients. Research expert Dr. Joel Bean, a surgical oncologist, explains the interest in T-cells.
The reason that T-cells have really been the focus is because they have the cytotoxic capacity to actually kill cancer cells. And so that's why T-cells have really been the focus of our research and for many of the cellular-based therapies up until now.
The research involves using organoids, tiny three-dimensional tissue cultures, which in this case are made up of the patient's tumor cells. Another member of the research team, Dr. Alexander Skardle, a biomedical engineering expert, says the organoids enable the team to study a patient's tumor from outside their body.
We use this bioengineered hydrogel extracellular matrix biomaterial that we sort of use to house all these cells. And so really it almost looks like a little droplet of this hydrogel matrix that it's made out of the same stuff that the cells live inside in your body. And so the cells kind of live there, and we trick them into thinking they're kind of still in the tumor or in another tissue in other cases. And then we can use that in the lab to kind of represent that patient's tumor for all sorts of studies like the immunotherapy studies we're doing here.
The advantage of the organoid approach is that it more closely represents how the T cells will behave in the patient's body.
The plan, the goal of this approach is really to try to educate these T cells or train them to attack a cancer cell and eradicate that from the body.
Dr. Skardle says the results of the team's research could have far-reaching implications for future cancer treatments.
The goal here is to help as many patients as possible, but this platform can be tailored to any type of tumor. So in the long run, we could use this as a test platform to figure out if T-cell therapies or natural killer cell therapies are appropriate for a given type of cancer, since some are, you know, considered immune hot and some are immune cold and less receptive.
Both doctors praise the Pelotonia grant for helping move their research forward.
For people like us who are new to Ohio State, these opportunities, these funding mechanisms are key for the growth of our labs.
It's hopefully going to provide the catalyst to allow us to generate a lot of preliminary data that we can really expand to generate more funding.
Pelotonia and the James at Ohio State, granting hope to cancer patients and the people working for a cancer-free world.